So today on the show we have Lynne Kuber is here.
Oh, yes.
She's a fantastic musician. She's also a psychic medium as well. Hi, Lynne.
Hello.
How are you? Thank you for being here today.
Thank you for having me.
And you're going to do two original songs for us, right?
Two originals.
Okay, yes. So what tracks are you going to do for us today?
I'm going to do Iqnore the Signs, which is kind of a psychic song in a way.
It's
also about knowing when a relationship is over with, and you kind of know it, but you don't know it, and you know, you've all been there.
Okay.
So Iqnore the Signs.
All right, sure. Take it away.
Of course, it comes from experience. I ignored the signs.
And your musician name is actually Idette.
Yes, I actually play keyboard and guitar and a little bit of banjo.
Okay, and how long have you been playing?
I've been playing, actually, guitar and writing songs since 94, 95, but I was a classical pianist from seven years old to first year high school. I took classical lessons.
Wow.
All of the Bach, Beethoven, and all of that.
So you can play piano?
I play piano, yes.
Wow.
Classical and all that. I don't play popular, because in the Catholic grammar school, you're not allowed to.
Okay.
And So anyway.
And you were telling me you have many songs written. You wrote
I have
like
actually
over
197 songs under copyright since 94, 95, but I have more that I've written. But
there's
197 under copyright. And they're in all styles. I write blues. I write R&B. I write folk. I write ballads. I have children's songs. I have Celtic. I've actually written some Civil War songs. I tease people and say I remember. I've been around that long. But my band and I, we performed at Grant Cottage, where Ulysses Grant went to write his memoirs. I wrote a song, Buffalo Soldiers, Ode to the Buffalo Soldiers, which I performed at the Egg for Martin Luther King Day.
Very nice.
I have a lot of songs. I believe most of my songs are channeled. They come in from another era. I have a lot of Celtic songs.
I was going to say, I see some Joni Mitchell in there.
Thank you. I've actually had comparisons for my ballad voice to Joni Mitchell, and my voice has been compared, and I take this with, Bonnie Raitt, Melissa Etheridge, Stevie Nicks, definitely not Whitney Houston. So
right.
Wouldn't even attempt to go there.
Wouldn't even touch that.
Phenomenal singer. I mean, the pipes, oh my God. And
yeah.
But I do what I do, and mm-hmm. I really don't consider...
And you write your own music.
This is all, it's
right.
Words and music. I write both.
So where does this inspiration come from in the music? Are these things that you experience or saw?
To be honest
through?
You, most of my songs have been either if I'm in my house, I'm just sitting there and the songs kind of come in. A lot of the songs I've written have come in totally written, all like they just come in. It's really incredible. Sometimes I'll be driving along and I'll see something, a sign, and it'll come in that way. I purposely, when I'm in the car driving, I do not listen to the radio. Mm. No offense to anyone else's music, but I just sit in quiet and the songs come in as I.
So do you hear the melodies first or the words come out? What
combination.
Do you
sometimes it's all written together.
Uh-huh.
A lot of times it's words. Usually I get the words first, then
okay.
The melody. But it's I have a whole pack of words with no music.
Wow.
That I've written also.
Wow.
So I have a lot of, you know, a lot of stuff written.
Fantastic. Is there somewhere online that they can check you out?
Yes. Actually, I go by Idette for my music,
uh-huh.
Idette, mm-hmm. And it's www.idetteandthesunrunners. I formerly had a full band, 5-person band. Now I'm down to a trio or duo. And I perform out, not as much as I used to, but here and there.
Okay.
I do a lot of benefits and stuff.
We'll definitely have to check that out.
Fantastic.
Thank you very much. And she's going to be doing another track for us later on in the show, so you don't want to miss that as well.